Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth will set you. You want to be free? Put on the belt of truth. You want to be free? Everything you see and do in life needs to go through truth, truth, truth. We should start the day with truth. We should end the day with truth. Truth. God is true. And in our world today, there's no such thing as truth. To quote the great theologian Deion Sanders, when you dress good, you look good. When you look good, you feel good. When you feel good, you play good. And when you play good, you're paid good. Truth, dynamic truth from Deion. Isn't it true? Some of us are fashion conscious and others are fashion unconscious. Wives, don't elbow your husbands. I think Grapevine is the capital city of the cargo short. What do you think? Guys, do we love cargo shorts or what? Kind of long, very forgiving. Disguise problem areas, pockets, and they go with anything. I mean, they look great with Crocs or dress shoes. You know, I hear that shorty shorts are coming back. That's brutal. Guys, don't wear shorty shorts. I mean, Tom Brady can, LeBron, but no, you can't wear them. And that's okay. Just stick with the tried and true cargo shorts. That'll do it. A friend of mine several years ago got this suit for me. It's tailor-made. What's my name? Isn't that cool? I don't know, it might have been 5 years ago, but anyway, who knows? I would have been an idiot not to get the suit made. I mean, it was paid for, right? And I would have been a bigger idiot to go, I'm not going to wear that. No, I know it's tailor-made, and I know it's expensive, and I know it's great, but I'm just not going to do it. I love this suit. I do. What if I told you that God has a suit for you that's tailor-made? What if I told you that this wardrobe that God has works in every single situation, and moreover, it gives us victory. Victory in marriage, victory with our family, victory at the office, victory on the golf course. It gives us victory as we do life. It's truly God's wardrobe, war, W-A-R, wardrobe, war. We're at war. We are at war, and it's easy to see we're in this cultural war. Just look back through history. You can go back to Aristotle, Plato. You got the pre-modern era, then you have the modern era, and now you have the post-modern era. Truth is up for grabs. Absolute truth is absurdity, they say. And we see the chaos and the craziness that this mentality has brought us. Truth. God gives us truth. The Bible says he is truth. It's who God is. He doesn't have to act true to be true. He's true. He's true. And he has a true wardrobe for every life here. As I said, we're facing war. And this war today is seen everywhere. I don't understand why pastors don't talk about the number one issue that's facing us today. Many don't. Wokeism. Or you can call it neo-Marxism, or you can call it a Marxerita. All of these ideologies are poured and shaken in one glass and truth is absurd and everything's about critical theory and racism and everything is about subjective truth. Why in the world pastors don't talk about it, I don't know. I don't think most pastors are woke. I think they're weak. But then again, I would say to a pastor, okay, you believe in the gospel? The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus? They would pretty much all say yes. Well, what if you didn't preach the gospel? Well, I don't want to do that because I don't want to offend anybody. The gospel is offensive. Standing for truth is going to be offensive. That's why the Bible calls it war. We are at war. And this is a DEFCON 1 situation. DEFCON 1 is there's an intimate threat from our enemy. The enemy, I'm talking about the devil himself, has a plan to take you out. God loves you, we know, and has a wonderful plan for your life. Satan loathes you. He hates you and has a plan to destroy you. But the good news is God has won. Jesus has dominated, and the devil doesn't want you to know that. He doesn't. But there's a cosmic war going on between good and evil, God and the devil. So what happens here can be connected all the way to what's going on there in the heavenlies. Once someone becomes a Christian, maybe you're a Christian, maybe you're not. If you're not, lean in, because I'm going to tell you what's going to happen in your life when you become a believer, because I believe if you hang around here very long, you'll become a believer. And if you're open to the things of God, you might not even believe God, but you say, God, if you're real, reveal yourself to me. I promise you, he'll do so if you're open to him. But let me talk to believers. Once you're born again, you're born for a battle, and you're born again to win. And this phrase, born again, means we're born into the family of God through Christ. The moment that happens, the Bible says we're in two places at once. We're in planet Earth, on planet Earth, in our life here physically, but also we're seated with Jesus in the heavenlies. Where are the heavenlies? I don't know. No one knows. Another dimension. You know, we only see a slice of the electromagnetic spectrum. We think we're smart and we can see all this stuff. You know, we can't see radio waves or gamma rays or infrared rays or x-rays. Hey, have you ever seen gravity before? It's a pretty powerful force. No. Have you ever seen hate before? I haven't. I've seen the results of it. Have you ever seen love before? No. So there's something going on over there in this dimension that affects what's going on here. We become Christians. We're seated with Jesus in the heavenlies. We're in two places at once. I was driving from here to Frisco about 45 minutes ago to speak there, and my brother FaceTimed me. I know you know what that is. And he's in Houston, yet he was really with me in my car in Dallas. Two places at once, and man has just figured that out. Well, God has been doing that, you know, for eons. So we're seated with Jesus. Also, the blessings are in the heavenly places. Your blessings and mine, they're in the heavenly places. The angels, your angel, my angel, is in the heavenly places. Demons are in the heavenly places. Again, we don't know where that is. Another dimension. So what goes on over there affects what goes on here. That's why I've been saying the battle you're fighting is probably not the battle you're fighting. I mean, it is a little bit. But you're seeing it in the physical. I'm seeing it in the physical, but it can be traced all the way to the spiritual. We are at war. The war is a cosmic war. The war is a cultural war. And the war is an individual war. Let's look at this DEFCON 1 series. Let's look at the war we fight. The war we fight. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 12 and 13. Our struggle, as I just unpacked, is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Who knows where that realm is, but it's there. Therefore, put on, I love this, get dressed, dress for success, the full armor of God. God gear, armor all, right? So that when the day of evil comes, I think you could say today is the day of evil, right? You may be able to stand your ground. I love this. And this stance is not on your heels. It's not weak. It's stand your ground. It's taking hell by the square foot. And every time I've taken hell by the square foot, by the glory of God, it's come with a price tag. It's an all-out war. The war we fight. Batman. I love Batman. I'm not talking about Michael Keaton, weak. George Clooney, even weaker. Christian Bale, come on, please, playa. I'm talking about the OG, Adam West. Because the first part of this wardrobe that we wear is the belt of truth. It's a spiritual utility belt. Batman always used his utility belt to get out of all sorts of problems. If you don't believe me, just watch this.
Batman, we're helpless in this monstrous invisible grip.
Steady, Robin. I see one hope.
What, Batman?
If I can just pry loose my utility belt transmitter.
Mr. Joker, are you ready to fire?
Yo-ho, ready to fire. 5, 4, 3, 2, fire on!
If I can just reverse the polarity, send out waves of super energy.
Paul says, put on your utility belt. It'll get you out of any situation. The belt was the centerpiece of a Roman's armor. Stand therefore, there's the word again, the phrase again, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness. So I am putting on this belt, and the belt is the main part of Roman's gear. And Paul gives us this wardrobe in order of how you put it on. A Roman soldier would have the armor. He would have on like a little short skirt, kind of like shorty shorts. Then he would have a toga. So when it was time to rumble, like Bruce Buffer says, it's time! When it was time, he would take his toga, tuck it into his belt, and then he could move, man. Because Jesus said, you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. You want to be free? Put on the belt of truth. You want to be free? Everything you see and do in life needs to go through truth, truth, truth. We should start the day with truth. We should end the day with truth. Truth. God is true. And in our world today, there's no such thing as truth. Do you realize how absurd that is? I've used this illustration numerous times. I had heart surgery in 2017. They split me from here to there. What if my surgeons had been a team of relativists? What if they said, you know, what's true to me is Ed needs his left arm amputated. That's true to me. What's true to me is he needs some toe work. His toes are really kind of jacked up. So we're going to do that. You cannot operate on relativism. You cannot do football or school or anything. It leads to complete absurdity. And that's what we're seeing in our world today. The devil is the father of lies. He's a liar. And so many of our leaders, so many of our politicians, so many of the A-listers, so many people we see on TikTok and Instagram and all that, truth. What is truth? And when you throw truth out, absurdity is there. We're fighting this war. This is a real battle. I remember when Lee Beth passed away 2 years ago, It was the most difficult thing our family has ever gone through. In fact, Lisa and I will never, ever get over it. We're writing a book, as I've been, you know, discussing with you, called A Path Through Pain. It comes out in November, and it's about this journey and some other journeys through pain. But the day after Lee Beth passed away, I was sitting in my office, and I talked to a guy. You might know who this guy is. Have you ever seen The Jesus Revolution? It's the movie about Greg Laurie. He's the pastor in Southern California. Greg had also lost a child about, 7 years earlier. And he told me something. He said, Ed, I want you to know that I'm praying for you and Lisa. But he said, here's what I want you to understand. Don't doubt in the dark what you learned and believed in the light. We'll face situations of darkness, of doubt, of questions, of why me, God? I'm a pastor, or who, whatever. Why do you allow bad things to happen to good people? And all of that. Don't doubt in the dark the truth that has set you free in the light. Fight. Fight. Because you're fighting from victory. So that's the belt. Having girded your waist with truth. Man, we're all about truth, right? In a world that doesn't even know what truth is. How about the body armor? That's another part of this wardrobe. So you've got the belt, it's the first thing you put on. Then you've got the breastplate of righteousness, having put on the breastplate or the body armor of righteousness. What is righteousness? God is totally righteous. It's who he is. Because he's totally as he should be, righteous. We say, oh man, he's righteous. That means just straight. Righteousness, righteousness. When I become a Christian, what happens? Boom! The righteousness of Jesus is transferred to my account. And because of that, because of the power of the gospel, I have an opportunity to lead a righteous life. So this breastplate would go with the soldiers wherever they went. As you look at your life, are you adding to your righteousness quotient by the activities, or are there activities that are taking away from your righteousness? It's a huge question for students, a huge question for young people, a huge question for those who are married, a huge question for single adults, a huge question for the blended family. So we've got the belt of truth. We got the breastplate of righteousness. Let me tell you how righteous you are. Picture a room, and there are two chairs. You're in one chair, Jesus is in the other, and God the Father is standing off to the side. What if I walked up to God the Father and I said, Father, which one of these is more righteous? Which one of these do you love the most? You know what God would say? Both. Are you ready for that? Both. If you know Jesus Christ, you have his righteousness, his standing put into your life. So when God sees you and me, he sees Jesus. The breastplate of righteousness. It covers our heart. It covers our back. I think Jesus invented that phrase, I got your back. Also the boots. So we put on the belt, we put on the body armor, then next we put on the boots. You know, shoes, we have to have shoes. And if you study history, Roman soldiers had these shoes that had thick soles. I'm talking about ridiculously thick soles. And the historian Josephus has cited time and time again that many armies secured victory because of their footwear. How about that? Well, these Roman sandals would have cleats on them so they could have a firm foundation. It's almost like, guys, when you hit the ball in the sand, you know, in the sand, you kind of dig in, or if you're a football player, you dig in. You don't just stand there, though. If you're neutral, you'll get caught in the crossfire. You move out. You conquer. You're victorious. You claim the land. When I was 5 years old, Remember at the beginning of this series, I told you I dressed up like the devil in my first Halloween? It was the same kind of time period, but I was enthralled with cleats. Back in the day, you couldn't buy cleats for five-year-olds, and my parents bought me a pair of Buster Brown dress shoes. And they took those Buster Brown dress shoes to the, I guess you call them the cobbler, is that right? Cobbler, cobbler, mend my shoe, have it done by 2:30. That's coming out on my children's album, but we might call it a shoe hospital. They put golf cleats on the bottom of my shoes. And I remember like it was yesterday, Mom and Dad go, Ed, here's a gift, open it up. Oh my gosh, cleats. I put them on, started running around the yard. Man, grass like up in the cleats, it was so cool, you know. Well, my friend Robert Campbell must have heard the commotion because he came over and he stood there. I was right by the dogwood tree. I'll never forget it. And he was looking at my cleats. He was having cleat envy. And something inside of me, because normally I'm very selfish, something inside of me thought, well, poor Robert, he doesn't have cleats. So I took one cleat off and gave it to him. So he had a cleat, and I had a cleat, and then we played football, yeah. Then we played baseball. Well, I mean, we had the time of our lives. Cleats, cleats, cleats. Having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. So we have peace. We have the peace of God because we have the peace and we made peace with God through salvation, through salvation. We're to share the gospel. What's the gospel? The death, burial, and resurrection. The gospel. I was saved. I am being saved. I will be saved. Justification, sanctification, glorification. The gospel, it's only by the power of the gospel that gives us the energy to dress. We don't have it on our own. I can't manufacture it. It's this God gear. So I've got to ask you, are you doing that? I talked to a young woman in a small meeting several days ago. And she has a hellacious background. Her family of origin, I cannot tell you how dysfunctional and how demonic and how brutal it was. And she just said, with tears streaming down her face, how is God going to use my background, you know? So she said she met a lady, a young woman, and this young woman began to share with her, and this young woman had the same background she did. And so she was able literally to take one cleat off and share it with her friend because her friend, who is here today, stepped over the line and gave her life to Jesus Christ. So it's great to be an example. It's great to believe the gospel. But when the Holy Spirit of God gives you an opportunity, share it. And also preach the gospel to yourself. Yeah. You're a preacher. I've got to preach to myself before I preach up here. I need this as much as you do. Does anybody here have a motion detector lighting system? Anybody? Oh yeah, you do. It's amazing, isn't it? We have one in our backyard because we have dogs. And if you walk in the darkness with dogs, you know what can happen. You can step into a landmine. This system has the stuff, it has the juice to detect your motion and come on. So you're in the darkness and you know it has the power to light up your path, but you have to take a step, and once it detects you taking a step, boom, the lights come on. God is saying, maybe you're a seeker. You need to become a believer. Take a step. Yeah. But Ed, it's dark. Take a step. Yeah. God's saying to the Christian homemaker, it seems like darkness is all around you. Take a step. You have the gospel boots on. Yeah. Take a step. Take a step. So number one, the war we fight, if you're taking notes. Number two, the wardrobe we wear. And number three, the win we secure. 2 Corinthians 15:57. Thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So what is God saying? What's he saying about being battle ready? If you dress good, you'll feel good. If you feel good, you'll play good. And if you play good, you'll get paid good. God will bless you. He will pay you in ways our world can't touch, here and in eternity. Would you bow your heads with me for a moment? Lord Jesus, it's our prayer as we bow our heads. It's our collective prayer to be tethered to your truth. As our heads are bowed and our eyes are closed, if you're a Christ follower, just put on the belt of truth. It's time to run things by the truth. It's time to understand and delve into the truth of God's word. Put on the body armor. God, give us the discernment to pick those areas that build righteousness and walk away from those that don't. Lord, as we put on the gospel boots, those shoes, we're ready for action. We're ready to take a step of faith into darkness. And we know the light will come on. Give us the boldness and the compassion to share your glorious gospel with others. Hey, if you're here and you're not a believer and you want to step over the line, you can make that decision right now by simply saying these words where you're seated. Just simply say, God, I admit to you what you already know, that I'm a sinner. I turn from my sins and I believe that you sent Jesus to come to this earth to die on a Roman cross and to rise again 3 days later, to die on the cross in my place for my sins. And right now I ask you, Jesus Christ, to come into my life. If you prayed that prayer, that's the greatest thing you'll ever do. And now you can discover this awesome wardrobe, which simply means to be clothed in Christ, that God has for you. Tailor-made. In Jesus' name we pray.
Hi guys, thank you so much for watching the Ed Young YouTube channel.
That's right, and if you want to be inspired, encouraged, and challenged like never before, subscribe and click the notification button.
We believe this channel can help change your life.